Welcome to a brand new episode of 420 Grams here on newsclick.in. I'm joined in the studio today by the man who hosts 575 Ounces, our cricket show, our fantastic cricket show. जो मतलब इस पूरे जहान में एक ऐसा क्रिकेट शो है जहाँ पे कमेंट यही आते हैं कि प्लीज़ भाई लोगों फुटबॉल वाला शो करो वैभव एंड सोप ऑपरा टेली नोवेला सुपरस्टार अर्जुन पंडित व्हेन द टूर्नामेंट बिगैन वन थिंग वाज फेयरली क्लियर दैट द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स आर द ओवरवेलमिंग फेवरेट्स टू एटलीस्ट मेक द फाइनल देन व्हाट हैपेंस इन द फाइनल इज अ सेपरेट मैटर बट द अदर टीम इज योर टीम The team that you've been following and watching through the tournament, yeah.
The European champions.
So, how's that been going and how have they sort of progressed through the tournament and developed? And
well, I think they've grown into the tournament. They had a, they won their first game right at the death. They had a very up-down game in their next round and slowly they've grown into the tournament. Good thing is that as they've grown into the tournament, a lot of different players have started contributing. A lot of different players have hit form. So, I still believe they go massive underdogs into the final, but that's a separate matter. They've done really well. And they're also a team and a nation that is fairly new to women's football in terms of development. This is only the second World Cup that the Netherlands have ever participated in. The first one was the previous edition. Between these two, they've won the European Championships. There is still no professional setup for women's football in the Netherlands. None of the players in their squad play in the Netherlands. They all play in other leagues. They play in France, some of them play in Spain.
All pros.
All of them, all the professionals, they play abroad. So it's, I mean, I think, but you can see also in the way that their team has been supported. Of course, a lot of their matches were in the north of France, which is close to the Netherlands. So their fans came down, it was like a 100-mile drive or something, and they flooded the stadiums. It was always orange. So it should be a good occasion. And regardless of whether they win or not, I do think that this will be like a new wave for women's football internationally, Dutch football. And it's always good to have the Dutch team do well in football. Gender no bar.
Hands down. Couldn't agree more with that yet. I mean, Dutch football, men's. I mean, remember that one time when they were not in the World Cup? Which was that? Recently. Recently, there was no Dutch team in the World Cup. And it's been a couple of years now that the men's team has been sort of dropping off. Yeah. And you can see that void in international football. And I was seeing highlights of the semi-final, which the Dutch beat Sweden in extra time, that goal.
Yeah.
Man, the intensity was good, yeah.
Yeah.
There was some decent intensity. And like Weber mentioned, the entire stadium was pretty much orange.
Yeah.
And the goal was a good 1-2, yeah. There's some good 1-2 play, ball aayi, jagah banai, and she took a short, low driver, whatever you call it. And you know, it was right in the corner, man. It was
and like
one of those low drivers which are tougher to save,
yeah.
As opposed to hitting those ones go in the air, you know.
Yeah.
So, I mean, they look pretty good, yeah.
They do.
Sense, you know, you could call it a David versus Goliath battle.
Yeah, I mean,
and
also,
sort of
like, I think
you,
it's typical Dutch, like their defense is very, very dodgy.
No, so wait, before you get into like specifics,
okay.
Do you feel like the gap between the US and the other teams in the competition, at least the European teams, okay, let's not overgeneralize, but some of the European teams, is that gap becoming a little bit narrower?
No, just to answer your question, bro, there is a huge gap, I still feel, and that gap, I think, can be measured. Not by this World Cup, but probably by the next World Cup, which is another four-year cycle. And then you can sort of start asking yourself if that gap between the US and the other teams is sort of, you know, chhoda kam ho raha hai ki nahi. This final, just let's not mention it was, it's been dubbed as the David versus Goliath battle, where Goliath is, of course, the US team. Now, the US team has won 3 World Cups, reigning world champions, 4 Olympic titles. But David, on the other hand, is not some airy team or a Saudi Arabia, Iran, or a team that no one expected to even reach the World Cup. Now, that team is none other than a European champion, bhai. So, you're calling a European champion and a world champion are basically meeting up in the World Cup final, which in every sense means that the top 3 teams, mein se jo 2 teams hain, wo mil rahi hain, but you're still calling it as one of those battles. You're still being dubbed as those battles. Purely because how far ahead US football is, women's football, as opposed to all the other. You have to give credit to US football that they jumped on this bandwagon way before anyone else.
Absolutely.
They saw the growth in Women's World Cup, they saw the growth in women's football, and they've been harping on this. They've reached at a certain level, not because they've, you know, suddenly woken up 4 years back.
No.
They've been awake for the last 15, 20 years.
1999.
And now they're being dubbed as, you know, yeah, 1999. Now they're being dubbed as the unbeatable side, or the Brazil of men's football, if you could call them that.
Mm.
And still the World Cup is at a very nascent stage. 1970 is unofficially when the first Women's World Cup took place.
Yeah.
So 1970 and 2018, kitna time hua hai yaar? Matlab 50 saal hone sirf yaar.
Hmm.
50 saal mein se agar har 4 saal baad ek World Cup karo, to mushkil se 10 World Cup hue.
Hmm.
So it's only 10 World Cups old, yeah. So I think we'll have to give it another 20 World Cups, 10 more possibly, just given how things exist in women's football and how things are progressing in women's football, because all the other factors come into play. It's not just what's happening on the field. That you can start thinking that you'll have clear, you know, that gap is diminishing year on with the big boys or the big women. So itna men's football karte hain, big boys hi bolte rehte hain.
No, it's true. Like I think I don't know. I mean, the gap is like a very fluid concept. Like in 2015, when they won, they beat Japan, they decimated Japan in the final. But in 2011, Japan beat them. At that point of time, suddenly there was talk of like, hey, you know what? There's an Asian powerhouse. Japanese football is on the rise. And this time, again, this is their third consecutive final. There is something they are doing right. There's a system they have in place.
Oh, yeah, for sure. So my only issue with the David Goliath, whatever analogy or story is that...
Who's Goliath?
No. Forget that. I mean, like... So in the end of that story, like David wins, right? I'm not seeing that happening really,
yeah,
as far as this game is concerned. But like you said,
I'm sorry. Jitna apna tajurba hai, sir, final hai, theek hai. Aur samne chahe koi alag level ki team ho, jisne sab kuch jeeta ho, jisko sab koi back kar rahe hain, but chahe jo bhi ho uske samne, sir, jab tak wo pehla goal nahi padta na, game on hai. आप चाहे कुछ भी बोल लो
नहीं गेम ऑन 100% गेम ऑन है 100% बट लाइक आई एम ओनली सेइंग सो नॉट एवरीवन इन दिस यूएस साइड हैज मे बी दे हैव ऑलरेडी वन एवरीथिंग बट कमिंग इनटू दिस वर्ल्ड कप आई थिंक जस्ट बिकॉज दे हैव बीन सो वोकल अबाउट सच अ वाइड रेंज ऑफ इश्यूज दैट They don't want to, and I mean, even stuff like Donald Trump getting into the act, man, and telling Rapinoe on Twitter to win first and talk later, right? So these are not the kind of characters that take that kind of thing and, you know, let it happen. I'm pretty sure they're going to be going out with some serious, serious fire, man.
I know.
And the level of intensity that we will see in this final will be something else, I'm pretty sure.
They have all the ammunition to go out there and get a win for themselves, hands down. You know, and even all the bad press. There's quite a lot of bad press that they've been generating as well for coming across as arrogant.
Yeah, so
and,
this is...
Seriously, screw you media that you can come around and do these kind of things. And since we're in the middle of a Cricket World Cup, right? This American team... And just for the way they display their, you know, that we are the best. And there's nothing wrong in doing that. They remind me of that Australian team. Remember? That Australian team. The best ever Australian team that we've come across.
Which one? Ricky Ponting or Steve Waugh's?
I think Ricky Ponting, though.
Yeah. Fair enough.
And
fair point.
Just you know, there is, in sportsmen, I don't think there's anything wrong with it, man. When you know that you have a team and a unit that can get past anyone, there's a sense of confidence that comes about in what you do. And a lot of people sometimes...
They're the best team in the world, right? So, when they go out to play, you can see the way they play, how much they enjoy it in their celebrations or whatever. I mean, I think the load of or the baggage that comes with being American, I'm not trying to defend... Like, what?
Gently said, the baggage...
Yeah. Has been unloaded on this team, where I mean, I don't think that should be part of the conversation at all necessarily. But
no,
at the
but
same,
it always will be, bhai.
Yeah, I guess.
Women's sport, yeah. See, the thing is, they're not just fighting for recognition on the field. They're fighting for a lot more off the field, to be honest. And, you know, just winning that World Cup will be a very small measure of what they've won. It won't be the only thing. Generally, in men's sport, men's football, aap jeet rahe ho, toh you're the best football team. That's it. Khatam. Yahan pe they're fighting for a lot more. And, you know, in a sense, they're breaking social boundaries. And when you start doing that, na, then you start touching every part of society. That's when everyone starts talking about you. That's when everyone starts, you know, starts keeping in mind what you're doing right now. If you're fighting for pay dispute. I mean, just imagine if Cristiano Ronaldo, before the Men's World Cup, had gone on to say, sir, main khelne nahi wala hu. I am retiring from Portugal kyunki mere ko nahi lagta yahan pe paise mujhe theek mil rahe hain. How many sponsors would have stuck on with the World Cup? You know, now these girls are doing that, man, and that is insane to see.
Well, actually, you put
that idiot present.
The girl who won the best player in the world, the Ballon d'Or, she didn't participate in the World Cup, citing these issues. She's Norwegian. Ada Hegerberg.
Norwegian, yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, that's a fair point.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
I think we need to get it. I think more, a lot, I hope that this is the start of the realization for television guys, because some of the numbers that have been shared by,
different
well,
networks.
I mean, they are, of course, these are official numbers shared by FIFA, so for what it's worth.
So give and take, eh?
Whatever, yeah, fair enough.
But still,
they are pretty encouraging, and I they're also not such unreal numbers that they're hard to believe, you know. It's not that they're claiming.
It's come now, na?
Sorry?
It's come now. I'm saying that, see, why will a television person or whoever is heading a channel say, look, this product is garnering so many numbers, why would I not want to be associated with it?
Exactly.
So
exactly.
Now you tell me the kind of people who would want to be involved for the next World Cup.
Yeah.
Or the next European Championship,
so
that number will rise.
Yeah, so what I think, essentially, we need to get much more games going and more of it on television or online so that people can watch, man, and get to know the... Because unless you're involved with the teams and the players, that sort of personal commitment that goes into being a fan doesn't come about, na? तो आप चार साल नहीं वेट कर सकते हैं अगले वर्ल्ड कप के लिए कि दोबारा जोश आएगा।
That's true.
हम मतलब we don't function on a 4-year cycle when we're talking about football, right? We are.
But I think in that sense, I think European women's football has moved ahead a bit. Like they don't do this just preparing for the 4-year cycle and only airing games for 4 years.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I mean, a big issue is that this entire whole exercise seems to be very Eurocentric.
Yeah.
So I'm hoping that like the Asian teams will now pick up, like India is starting to, I guess, think a little bit, invest a little bit in the women's
game.
Yeah,
but I think they're still very far away from the world stage. But
no, I'm just talking about in terms of
कहाँ पे थे जहाँ जा रहे हैं
हाँ
कहाँ पे थे जहाँ जा रहे हैं तो it's progress, of course it is progress. I also think that these girls, because so from an Indian point of view, now when you see these girls standing up and fighting for issues beyond the field, that in itself has a bigger connect. Or a Rapinoe saying, look, my free kick is not coming out right, my fatigue is not coming out right, wo sab theek hai, but wo Rapinoe jab bolti hai ki yahan pe, you know, pay dispute is not right, there are sexual allegations against certain teams and all, and so on and so forth, and you've got to fight societal norms and everything. That in itself has a connect with someone sitting in India and watching it. A girl who harbors dreams of playing football or whatever, you know. That, you know, you have these people doing it on this stage. And maybe I can try doing it at my level, whatever small level it might be. I think to grow women's football in India, if we are to take example, the importance is to get more female coaches there. Because they can form a connect. Because, you know, you've always got a dude who's sort of telling these girls to come and do whatever they can, fight society, that connect is always missing. As opposed to, you know, you have a female who's been there, done that. And, you know, that's the way forward. Which is why you hear so many good things about Rocky Maimor. Because a lot of these girls connect with her. You know, at whatever level. And, you know, if she's telling them that you go out there and give your best for whatever it is you have to do, then, you know, they somewhat take it in, it seeps in, and, you know.
I think, yeah, I mean, so with her, I think one of the major reasons, especially with this young set of players that she's got now, is a basic thing ki, yaar, have fun. Play like fun football. You know, keep the ball, enjoy it, move around. Like enjoy playing the game. Not necessarily go after the results. And that is what has managed to get like a backing from or get that spirit going in terms of
that seems like
what
such a,
she's
like
done.
This is just seems like such a that every coach should have that like be saying that to
no
them.
So this is
no
yeah
they can't do this all the time. I mean once they go up a level this play of a fun sort of scene will have to change somewhere or the other, but right now I think just at the stage where the Indian team is, just to go out there regularly, play games, enjoy yourself should be aim number one. Then once you start hitting a level and you start consistently getting results, then you start going deeper and deeper into it, I'm pretty sure. And
I mean, one can also hope that like everyone who's watching the Women's World Cup, any Indian investors who are watching the Women's World Cup also realize that actually investing in women's football is perhaps a safer route and more guaranteed success than men's football, and maybe that helps out, no? Like it's a smaller investment,
know.
Yeah?
I think you do an investment from a point of view of how many people are watching you, na? Also.
Yeah, but
I
this is like a small
that
risk investment. It's you're not like putting a lot of money in.
Yeah, I mean to be honest, I'm pretty put off with the whole way that football is direction that football is going, man. And like
world.
Yeah, yeah. For what it's worth, like
thank you for watching.
I feel like as long as in some way I get the things that a lot of the top athletes are fighting for are extremely critical in a larger sense, but jitna ye zyada jo basically jo hum ye professionalization bolte hain, essentially it's just commercialization, right? Everything just becomes more and more geared towards that result. You stop playing for fun. And it's a weird sort of cycle. But
sir, but agar aapko success lana hai, paisa lana hai, to commercialization to lana hi padega na. I mean, they go hand in hand.
I know, yeah. It's so there has to be a balance, I think. And perhaps
main sochun ki main 10 rupees laga raha hu aap pe aur aap log khel rahe ho par aapko koi dekh nahi raha. तो मैंने एक साल लगा दिया 10 रुपए, 2 साल लगा दिया 10 रुपए, मेरे को रिटर्न 2-2 रुपए का मिल रहा है, तो मैं क्यों लगाऊंगा
यार हर चीज,
मैं
मतलब
जितना भी देशभक्त हूँ या जो भी हूँ.
नहीं नहीं
आप सोचो ना, अगर 10 रुपए की इसमें आपको 2 रुपए रिटर्न मिल रहा है, इट्स लाइक स्टिल
ये यार आउट ऑफ मे बी आउट ऑफ मे बी 10,000 मेन्स फुटबॉल क्लब्स इन द वर्ल्ड, आई डोंट नो हाउ मेनी, देयर मस्ट बी मच मोर, लाइक 5 मेक अ प्रॉफिट यार. एंड व्हाई आई मीन वी आर एट द एंड ऑफ द डे वी आर डूइंग स्पोर्ट मैन, वी आर डूइंग we're encouraging what we consider the some of the greatest achievements in human endeavor, right? It's like art. You support it, you give it whatever kind of patronage you can, whatever society can afford.
Yeah, so
and
then
football is the same
already, then somewhat, so in some way or the other you already sort of accepted ki ha yahan pe to main thoda, you know, usko survive karne ke liye main de raha hu. तो आप अभी भी उसी लेवल पे हो ना, अगर आपको उस ऊपर वाले लेवल पे आना है, then you have to get into the big rat, you have to get into the rat race ना भाई. यहाँ पे अगर आपको सपोर्ट वाली कहानी है तो ठीक है, यहाँ मैंने थोड़ा चैरिटी दे दिया, वहां थोड़ा मैंने चैरिटी दे दिया, चलो ठीक है,
नहीं नहीं,
at the end of the day you're still stuck on that level, right?
Anyway, I think this is also maybe a bit tangential.
I think
like,
this is a different show.
Yeah. So one of the major talking points throughout, from I think the first game till the last game, has been VAR. Firstly, I want to understand, is the Women's World Cup being treated as a guinea pig tournament in terms of this new decision to review everything, all the goals, all the goals and offside? I don't know. I don't even understand
exactly
what the scene is. So I don't, what do the referees do anymore?
I think in the Women's World Cup, the one add-on to the VAR has been checking for the penalties. When they're doing penalties, how the goalkeeper can come off the line. Offsides, red cards, and fouls in the box were used even in the Men's World Cup. So that's standard.
But goals were not compulsorily reviewed at the World Cup, I'm pretty sure.
They were.
Not a chance. Maybe on television they did something, but like, there was no gap between a goal being scored and the celebration. Unless, I mean, it was not compulsory.
No, it wasn't. It wasn't compulsory.
Yeah, VAR. No chance.
VAR was only called upon when you asked for it.
Yeah.
No, who asked for it?
Was the referee team fit?
The referee. There's no review system. The referee decides when he needs his virtual assistant to assist him.
But
and at that point, he goes and asks.
It's telling him, sir, check karo.
Haan. वो बात करते हैं ना
नो बट फॉर ऑफसाइड्स वाज स्टिल बीइंग यूज्ड ड्यूरिंग द मेंस वर्ल्ड कप
ओनली बट नॉट इट वाज नॉट यू नो नॉट इट वाज नॉट कंपल्सरी 100% ऑफ द टाइम
अभी दे वर नॉट श्योर
अभी गोल हो जाता है उसके बाद 3 मिनट बाद ओ ये गोल
ओके या लाइक दैट हां
क्या बात कर रहे हो सही में
हां यार
या या एब्सोल्युटली इट्स बेसिकली दे सेलिब्रेट देन दे हैव टू वेट देन द रेफरी चेक्स गेट्स अ मैसेज फ्रॉम पेरिस देन
Wherever the message is coming from, like outer space, it's like a
bullshit rule. Yeah.
Yeah, for me, it's one of the enduring images of this tournament. When I don't know what game it was, but one of the France games, when Gauvin's goal was disallowed, I think, just basically woman fan just. Like booing the hell out of this VAR because you know if the referee has given you have to have that human element man in the game otherwise what the hell is going on, I remember and this fits into the larger conversation about the direction in which football is going
okay like there is this basically what you're saying is subjectivity Now, where like, I'm just sorry, like, I don't know why I always do this, but I'm bringing like another sport using umpire reviewal system into football. And that subjectivity is what you are looking for, right? So, say in the semi-final, England's equalizer, which was denied, was because of an offside. Ellen White, it was. She was offside by like a few centimeters. And those centimeters did not give her any advantage. No advantage at all. In scoring the goal. And those centimeters would have gone unnoticed if VAR was not around. Now, obviously, the rule is clear. That if you're offside, you're offside. It's not about how much you're offside
by. Yeah.
But the subjectivity is where this comes into play. It's like, what is it called in cricket? Umpire's call. If you understand what
umpire's call.
But that umpire's call in cricket, the way it's used is to like protect the umpire. Here, I mean, maybe,
sir,
I don't know.
Sir, all technology is
to protect.
Made to protect the umpire only, first and foremost. Aap chahe kuch bhi kar lo, at the end of the day, agar aapka koi aapne on-field decision galat diya hai, aur aapko ek review wahan pe aaya hai, to wo bhi aapko bacha hi raha hai at the end of the day, taki koi ye na bole ki is umpire ne hame game hara diya. Theek hai? To aapko ek review mila hua hai. But ये celebration वाला this is bizarre man.
Yeah. It ruins the game like.
मतलब मैंने यहाँ पे goal मार दिया है and मैं wait कर रहा हूँ और मैं timing चल रहा है ये goal.
No.
Yeah.
It's even worse when you like आपने goal कर दिया आपने celebrate कर दिया. And then आपको 10 मिनट बाद बोला गया कि actually you know like we're checking there's a nervousness that whole tempo comes down.
Stadium
choke. Goal again. Like then again you were celebrating all like
I have a feeling this is going to be a one-time experiment only and
in which case it's like
do it during the World Cup that is bizarre. I mean I thought this was the Hero Intercontinental Cup okay fine perfectly fine
yeah
not the World Cup
yeah but, sure and plus these things I mean it's surprising that these things you're right like that is a very good point you've made where why is this being experimented on in the Women's World Cup like why not try it in a I don't know Champions League pe kar lo yaar लड़कों के चैंपियंस लीग पे कर लो आप कर लो टेस्ट
कहाँ मतलब क्यों कर रहे हैं हम ये सब टेस्ट
नहीं
नहीं चाहिए
मैं कहीं ना कहीं आपको देखो सर
There are so many games I watched in this World Cup where they are adding on like 7 minutes injury time, 9 minutes injury time. And this is not because this is not injury time anymore. It's VAR time.
Yeah.
Seriously.
You cannot because have. It's not.
I'll give you the other side of it. If by adding 3-4 minutes extra to a 90-minute game or a 94-minute game, you're thereby cutting out any cost of error to a team that may have prepared for 3-4 years for a tournament,
and
a team that may get knocked out of a tournament courtesy that one decision, I think that team will be more than happy with that.
I think in life these things balance out, man. And like, ऐसे अगर हम zero error basis पे अगर हम करने लग गए चीजें तो हम फिर sport
क्यों करेंगे? I've just remembered like something that Colonel Gautam Kar, who used to be the head of referees for India. Last year before the World Cup, I had gone and met him. And this is the similar conversation we were having where I was asking him how much VAR helps referees or like why does India not get in VAR?
This is an excellent point. Go on.
Okay, like why does India not get in VAR and what is the kind of money for cost benefit? Like what is the benefit? It comes in. And he said, why not just train referees better? Yeah? That's all.
Yes.
That's all. Just put the money into training
referees. You make a choice between investing in like really expensive technology or investing in people.
Absolutely.
And if people are not involved in football, then why the hell are we doing football?
Sir, chalo ji, Colonel Kar ne jo baat boli, badi achhi baat hai, and I'm not even contesting that. But aap mujhe keh rahe ho ki agar aap ek World Cup ke liye jo aap apne referees hand pick kar rahe ho, you think they have not been trained to the fullest of their potential?
Yeah, and I think you should give them the run of it.
No, absolutely. I'm sure they've been trained. And in all fairness, Colonel Carr's statement was in reference to India, of course. But the point is that we've agreed, right, that we are all in agreement that VAR protects the referee more than anything else.
Yeah.
So what happens when you provide a human being protection from a wrong decision that he might take, that he will in the future take? You give him a shield and you say, sir, you don't have full confidence. What are
you saying?
No, I'm sorry. I was cracking a bad joke.
Like, you basically said to him that we don't have confidence in your decision-making skills 100%. So, we would prefer if you didn't make all the crucial decisions all the time. And this seeps into different sports. Huh? Like
this is not that. Again, I think you're missing the point. Because this is not a shield. This is a compulsory thing.
Absolutely.
Not that we don't trust.
The compulsory part, I don't agree with.
Yeah, that's all. I mean, I don't know if this is the first. Also, I should have checked this before, but I don't know if this is the first World Cup where all the referees are women.
Yeah.
Assistants, etc., etc.
Yeah.
Except the VARs.
Yeah, the VARs are mixed.
Right. Okay.
Like, don't tell me you're finding an angle.
I'm not finding any angles. I'm just asking a question. But so this is the first
innocent face.
This is the first World Cup where all the referees are women, and you use this to do this nonsense. I mean,
sir, no. One second, sir.
It's like double undermining.
You're living in a time and age where VAR has been is being used regularly now. So, usme uska koi lena dena nahi hai ki yahan pe scheme ho gaya ki sari aurte yahan pe referees bani hui hain, to chalo unko VAR de do because decision making utna acha nahi hone wala hai. We can foresee it.
No, that's not the point. The point is that everyone knows the Women's World Cup is a tournament, a global level tournament in which they can afford to do some experimentation. That's all. That's the point. ये men's World Cup में नहीं कर सकते थे आप कर ही नहीं सकते थे ये वाला experimentation. इन्होंने पिछला World Cup women played on artificial turf.
But somebody should really have issues with this stuff. Like you're saying that so many fans, it's the biggest sold ticket-wise World Cup in history, and then you're not allowing them to celebrate goals being scored because you want.
I think that is perhaps for me that should be the for not using VAR, that simple thing. That visceral like joy that you get out of seeing a goal being scored and the goal scorer and the fans, that's gone. Now it's like watching an LBW decision on DRS.
Anyway, okay. So that was fun, guys, and we've been chatting for I think an hour now.
Yeah.
So this will.
We've been chatting for an hour. There's no one in the studio. They've left the cameras and gone away.
I think we've been missing in action for so long. I have not had the opportunity to talk to you guys in a few days. So I was feeling extra verbose today. Thank you for the lovely chat, guys. Maybe.
You're welcome.
Yeah. So Women's World Cup final, Sunday, predictions? Anyone?
Yeah, sure. We can do some predictions.
Go on.
3-0 USA.
Wow. Boom shakalaka.
3-0 USA.
I love the Netherlands. They're not this time.
I'm going to be the odd one out, man. I go Netherlands. Both GT and USA.
Netherlands for the win.
Like, Netherlands can't win a World Cup, yeah. The ghost of Rinus Michels. Like, it's not going to happen, yeah. I mean, it'd be beautiful if they won.
Look, England can't win a World Cup ever. They're in the semi-finals, huh? Cricket World Cup.
It should be a fun game. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to it. And we'll catch you guys with, I think the next episode, we'll talk about Indian football a bit more. What's been going on with the clubs
Intercontinental
and
Cup.
Those conversations, what's happening with the national team. Of course, the Intercontinental Cup starts next week. Yeah, hopefully we'll have the energy to do this again soon. Thanks for watching.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.